Sometimes I call him Jabber Jim, 'cause he loves spinning a fishing tail. He's called a hundred, so he claims, master of the guild game, a typical sporting angling man. But now he doesn't boast, he turns whiter than a ghost as he recounts the one that got away. He swears that it was this big swam up spit out his rig, took off and gave him the middle fin. That was 2 weeks ago, down by the levee, and he ain't been the same since that day. All his usual sweet spots have all gone cold, 'cause he can't seem to get away from damn fishing, casting on the rocks, damn fishing, trawling up and down the blocks. I've never seen him acting quite like this, no telling how many days of work he has missed. Damn fishing. Morning, noon, and night, he's just waiting on that bite so he can reel up the proof for all to see. His wife, I think, is quite fed up. I'm pretty sure she's had enough indulging his fishy fantasy. I hadn't heard from him in days, so I motored round the way just to make sure that he was still alive. Something tells me that he won't be if he don't wake up and see that she's at the end of her line. She was standing on the dock as I pulled up and called out, "Hey, I'm looking for Jim, Miss Pat." As she just shook her head and with anger she said, "Where do you think that sorry sack is at? He's damn fishing, casting on the rocks, damn fishing, trawling up and down the blocks. He ought to be home working this honey-do list, but instead he's over yonder flicking his wrist, damn fishing." Maybe he's gone depressed. Hell, I think he just might be obsessed with damn fishing. Out there every day, damn fishing. He's getting carried away.